everyone, I'm Krista Seiden, Analytics Advocate at Google, and today I'm joined by John Mesh, who is a Product Manager on Google Optimize. In this quick tip video, John is going to walk us through reporting on optimized data in Google Analytics and how you can use that data to really get more insight into that test and how those test users are impacting the rest of your site metrics. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and hand it over to John.
Great, thanks Krista. So one of the first decisions that we made when we built Optimize was we decided to use Google Analytics measurement natively with Optimize. So there's no separate measurement data, there's no deduplication or reconciling different conversion rates. It's all just Google Analytics data. And that does a couple of things for us. Number one is we can use all of those objectives that we already have, which we've shown in previous setup videos. And we also have this reporting interface in Optimize that has a lot of power and simplicity to it. But it also means that we can go back into Google Analytics and do deeper dives on that data. So that's what we're going to do right now. So this is a test that I showed in a previous quick tip video. And we're going to go actually to the linked report in Google Analytics. Now this is the same property in the same view. And what I've done here is I've gone down to my all pages report within behavior. And I've already navigated to my basket page because what I want to see here is how many users for that test actually made it to the basket. I want to see how that test impacted them. And remember the original on this particular test, just the original, but the variant was redirecting users coming from YouTube to a YouTube specific merchandise page on our Google merchandise store. So what I'm going to do here first is add a segment, and this segment is going to filter out to that particular test. So let's create that segment right now. We're going to call this Optimize YouTube Brand Test. And I'm going to add a condition. In this case, I'm going to add the experiment name. Now, if you have a lot of experiments, you might actually find it easier to use ID, but in this case, we just got a couple. So we're going to grab that YouTube brand redirect experiment and go ahead and save that segment. Now, this has created a segment and it's going to apply that to this page. And I can see right here that I've got 228 page views of users who saw that test and got to the basket. That's great, but the next thing that I want to see here is how did their performance differ by variant? So in this case, we're going to add a secondary dimension. I'm going to go ahead and type in variant here. Now, what this is doing is, again, using that data that's sent into GA from Optimize and will show up exactly which variant the user saw. Now, we just show the numbers of the variants right here, and you can go back and reference that against Optimize. They're in order. So original is 0, YouTube brand page is 1. And I can see that a few more people did actually get to the basket when they had that particular test. So about 133 came there, and I can see some other interesting statistics and metrics on them as well. Now, the other really cool thing that I can do here, there's a few other things actually. One is that I can make a custom report with all of this information. So if I want to create a report just for one test, or maybe a report for a few tests, I can do that. I can also take this segment that I've built and I can turn that into an audience. And this is one of my favorite features here because we can use that with Optimize 360 and target those same users back on the site. So if I want to chain together these experiments and say that people who saw one variance of a test, I can actually expose them to another test down the road to see how they behave in conjunction. Because, so see our other quick tip video on that for how to build an audience and some interesting examples of audiences that you can use. But that's just some of the power of the integration that Optimize and Optimize 360 have with Analytics and Google Analytics 360.
Great. Thanks, John, for showing us how to really get more out of that optimized data by looking at it in Google Analytics and across the rest of your website metrics.